Even though you have sold everybody you have also, even though you have sold numbers 1 and 2, I will want to repeat to explain your answers in a shorter way. So, for number 1, you can draw this midline. Midline is a line that joins midpoint of midline. And each of these two parts is a parallelogram because it has two sides. A and B. A is equal to B because these are midpoints, and A is parallel to B because the big one is a parallelogram. Therefore, this is a parallelogram and this is a parallelogram. In a parallelogram, diagonals bisect each other. So these are, this is the midpoint of the diagonals. So therefore, the area of this small triangle is 1/4 of this parallelogram. Each of these, all the four are equal by our very first theorem, when we took the median, bisects the area, the median bisects the area of a triangle, so this area is equal to this area is equal to this, and so we have four equal parts. 1/4. And this is 1/4 of this parallelogram, the same thing. So together they make 1/4 of the entire thing. And well, in general, if you have, for example, I don't know, some figure, and it is divided into two pieces, and then you take 1/4 of this piece, and then you take 1/4 of this piece, then these two pieces together will be 1/4 of the whole. So it is not necessary even to say that these two parallelograms have the same area, although it is obvious in this case. And I noticed that you made this remark about this addition of two pieces for question 2, because here we can do it this way. So let's draw this diagram. So let's take one of the two triangles, for example, this one. So now, well, you worked hard to prove that this is 1/3 of the triangle, but what we have here is, this is the median, right?
Yes.
This is the median.
Yes.
So this is the centroid, the intersection of the median.
Yes.
And we know, we have seen that these three triangles have equal areas. So this area is equal to this one and this equal to this one. So this is 1/3. This is 1/3. Of the red triangle. Absolutely in the same way, this will be 1/3 of the green triangle. In fact, the triangles are congruent. They not only have equal areas, but they are congruent. But I don't care. This is 1/3 of this one, this is 1/3 of this one, so together it's 1/3 of the parallelogram, and that's it. You don't have to calculate all the small pieces, though in a maybe in a more general setting that would be useful. So 3 or 4? No?
4. The third rectangle is parallelogram.
This?
Yes.
Well, actually this is a rectangle in this problem, but it doesn't matter, it can be a parallelogram just as
well.
Yeah, but it doesn't matter if you want, because we know that you can take a parallelogram and make it a rectangle. So, if you want to use this, you can even make it a square. Maybe it will be easier.
The first problem is about the rectangle.
The first?
The third.
The third. As I said, it doesn't matter. You can take a parallelogram and make it a rectangle. If you want to use the fact that it's a rectangle, you can use it. Maybe it will help. But in fact, the points are the same.
Yes.
But you can you can use some of the things that we used here and here. Because the lines are the same ones. But they here they are.